So how do you prioritize issues or interests at stake in a negotiation? Well, there are several approaches you can use. First off, most people would say that prioritizing the interests based upon their importance to you or their importance to the other person should be the primary approach. You could go either way there. You could say dealing with the important issues first or dealing with the less important issues first and then working your way up to more important issues. Another more sophisticated approach would be to identify whether the interests at stake are either distributive, compatible, or integrative in nature. And we talk about what is a distributive negotiation or interest and what is an integrative interest in different video sections. But in summary, a distributive interest is where your both parties have the exact same interest at stake and those interests conflict. Okay, so those are going to be more difficult to achieve some level of concession in or some level of agreement upon. Now, a compatible interest means that you're both going in the same direction. That is, you want the same outcome for the interest. The problem there is oftentimes parties don't realize that interests are compatible in nature. So with that being said, they end up arguing for an outcome that's not in their best interest, not what they want, actually, and it ends up hurting both parties. And then an integrative negotiation is where parties value the same interest but differently. One party will value the interest more than the other, and likewise, when there are multiple interests at stake, the other party will value a different interest more or less than the other party. So that gives the opportunity for trade-offs between the parties in the negotiation, so you can create additional value for each party in the negotiation. Now, when you have integrative and compatible interest, it makes sense to put those at the very beginning. You deal with those and address those first, and then you bundle in together distributive issues as kind of a form of concession. That is, where one party gives up on an interest in a way that allows the other party to gain more value in that interest in exchange for doing better in others. So it allows you to loop these distributive interest or negotiation points in with compatible and integrative. So in a way to make the whole negotiation integrative in nature. Okay. And then another approach would be to try to identify which interests are dependent upon each other. That is, if one change in one interest or aspect of the negotiation changes another interest or aspect in the negotiation. If you can identify those, keeping those dependent interests or issues together will allow you to, bundle them in a way that allows you to trade off where, we both have the same level of interest in the primary issue in the negotiation, but the secondary issues are less important. So if you can bundle to one party than the other, so if you could bundle them together, it may be effective in getting the other party to make a concession or move towards a settlement point or a potential point of agreement between the two. So just to rehash again, prioritizing issues based upon importance to you or the other party, if you can identify that. Identifying whether they're distributive, compatible, and integrative so you can use them strategically to bundle together and ultimately work towards an achievable outcome, or identifying whether any of the interests are interdependent on each other, and again, combining or bundling those together to move towards a potential agreement on the collective or larger group of interests rather than taking them the interest individually.